Good morning.
Ooh.
Good morning.
I am spicy. Okay. Well, it's good to be with you all. Merry Christmas to you all. As we celebrate the Christ child's birth today, we get to hear from our young people as they were going to sing some of our favorite to join along with them. And so up on your screens this morning, we have the lyrics to our songs. And the parts that are written in regular type are our children going to be singing them. But then we invite the congregation to join along with us when the words are in bold type. So we can have a celebration together of the Christ child's birth. We're going to get to see the retelling of this as we read through Luke 2 and a little bit from Matthew chapter 1 and Matthew chapter 2. To remind us of what Christ has done for us. And so as we begin our program today, we'll invite our children forward as they sing, O Come, All Ye Faithful. And again, thank you for being here. God's blessings to you and Merry Christmas. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child.
Thank you.
And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And in the same region, there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased."
Thank you.
When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured up all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them. Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And assembling all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it is written by the prophet, 'And you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. And from you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod summoned the wise men secretly and ascertained from them the time the star had appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word, that I too may come and worship him." After listening to the king, they went on their way. And behold, the star that they had seen when it rose went before them, until it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed to their own country by another way.
Oh,
Well, Merry Christmas to you all. Wonderful blessings to you and your family in this time of our Christ child's birth. Experiencing something new or something that no one else has ever seen or done before is incredibly rare. In fact, there's a famous line in the Bible from the book of Ecclesiastes that says there's nothing new under the sun. And what it means is this, that anything you experience has usually, most likely, been experienced by somebody else. The idea being that if you're in the midst of suffering, you're not alone. If you're in the midst of something that's exciting, someone else has probably done that before as well. That we don't have that many experiences that are new and unique to us. Every now and then something might happen, but even if something is new to you, or even the first person in your town or your state to accomplish something or maybe have a new piece of technology, somebody else has thought of it before. And so when we see something that is actually perfectly new, that is rare, and it is special. Christmas, of course, is not a new idea. We've been celebrating this for close to 2,000 years, right? We've been celebrating the birth of the Christ child, and so the songs that our children are singing are songs that we've heard for years and years and years. The story of the Christ child's birth is one that you've heard for years and years and years, but we so often forget that what we're hearing about in Luke chapter 2 is a completely unprecedented event. Sure, the virgin gives birth to a child. That in and of itself is a miracle, but something even far greater than that is happening. Do you realize that the Christ child, by being born, is doing something that's never happened before? God is becoming part of his creation. The Creator is becoming part of his creation. This is akin to if a person who made pots, a potter, would himself take on the form of clay and become a pot. This is unprecedented. This is new. This is something that never has happened before in the entirety of the world. And the reason it happened is because of the same reason, or the reason it happened is because of another new an unprecedented event that occurred only far long before Luke chapter 2. The unprecedented event is, of course, the disobedience of Adam and Eve as they ate the forbidden fruit, as they plunged the world into sin and darkness, and they brought the power of death into the world. That was new. And so God saw the terrible situation of his people, and he swore to bring about something unprecedented, to bring about something that was completely new, and he would send Emmanuel, which translated means God with us. Our God took on our human flesh. Our God took on our human struggles. Our God took on the pain and the trouble and the death of our lives to be born into a manger, to be born in a stable, to be born to an unwed mother and her fiance, to be born into a world of sin, pain, and death. This was completely new to bring about another completely new event. God then died. God died on his creation. He died there because he took on our death, he took on our sin, he took on our pain and our darkness. And that's what we celebrate this Christmas. Every Christmas, a new event, several new events that bring us a hope and deliverance that nothing else possibly could. You see, the problem we're facing is not a problem that we can solve. It's not a problem that no matter how many new ideas we come up with, no matter how many innovations we create, we can never truly make ourselves worthy of God's love, or make ourselves perfect, or make ourselves sinless, but we must live with the reality that we are a broken people. Bad things happen to us, sometimes by our fault and sometimes not. And that's why God brings a new thing into our world. He brings His Son. And He does it for you. God does this brand new, unprecedented thing because He loves you. Because He loves me. Because He wants us to live forever with Him. And He provides us a forgiveness. He provides us a life. He provides us an eternity because of His bringing about this new thing. The birth of Him, of His Son. The incarnation, the in the flesh Emmanuel, who to this day dwells with you and with me and with all of us. So this Christmas, remember, God has done something new. God has provided you with a hope that you can find nowhere else. That even though our world is broken by sin and death, our Lord was broken by our sin and death so that we could live and live forever. Merry Christmas to you all. And may you find a hope and a peace in that new thing that God did for us in His Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, grant that the birth of your only begotten Son in the flesh may set us free from the bondage of sin. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.
Thank you.
Good morning. Merry Christmas to you all. Once again, thank you for joining us here at St. Paul's. I just have a few announcements I'd like to make. For the next 2 weeks, we will not have confirmation on Wednesday evening. We're going to give our students a break. So the next two weekend, or the next two Wednesdays, no confirmation. And the next two Thursdays, no Thursday morning Bible study. So keep those in mind. Next week, next Saturday is, of course, Christmas Eve. We're going to be having service here at 5:30, a candlelight service at 5:30 here at St. Paul's. And then out at St. John's in the country, we will be having a service at 7. So keep that on your calendar to celebrate the Christ child's birth. And then Christmas Day, which is also a Sunday, we'll be having a service here at 9 a.m. So please join us for that. We also do need, if you want to stick around for a little bit to help put the lectern and the pulpit and put some of this stuff back together, we need some able-bodied individuals to help us do that. And so God's blessings to you all, and have a Merry Christmas.